Welcome to Shishi in Parshas Vayetze. So Shishi describes the departure of Yaakov from Laban. And it describes how he packs up everything. So it says, as Kol Rechusho Asher Rachash, he takes all his possessions, and he goes and he's heading Lavo El Arz HaKanaan. He's coming to Arz HaKanaan. One of the things that's a highlight of the story is Vatignov Rachel Es HaTrafim Asher Lavia. Rachel steals the Trafim. His loved one's package of idols that he used to worship, Rachel steals. Now, as they're moving along, the word gets to loved one that Yaakov ran away, and it says Vayidova Charav Derech Shavas Yamim, and it says that loved one takes his whole group and they run after, and they come to Har HaGilad. At Har HaGilad, Hashem comes to loved one in the dream and warns him. First, he really tells him not to speak to Pentidaber Im Yaakov Mitov Ra. Don't say a word to him, because Laban does talk to him, but really it was supposed to be careful, I'm watching, don't try anything. They have a discussion, and Laban says, you know, my idols are missing, what's going on here? And Yaakov gives a whole speech about how he's worked and he never took an extra thing. He's been honest. He never cut his days short. He was 100% everything. Now you're accusing me of stealing. So he tells him, go look. And it says, Vayavo Lavan Ba'ol Yaakov, Ba'ol Leah. He comes into each of their tents. And the Torah then tells us that Rachel put the trafim in the camel. And then she comes in the tent and she takes it from the camel and she's sitting on it. When he comes into the tent, Rachel says, you know, I know I'm supposed to stand up, but I'm having, she says, Derech Nashem, which probably means she had her period. And she says, I can't stand up because it's affecting me negatively. In the end, they have this machlokas, and Yaakov says, you know, what did you find? You didn't find anything. And Yaakov says that whoever took the trafim, they'll be accountable for it. Yaakov believing that it was 100% not in his possession.